In this video, I would like to show some basic and important points of Tai Chi before you actually do Tai Chi. We start from the head. We call it hanging, head hanging, when we translate it into English. Imagine you have a string connected to the tip of your head, and it pulls your body up. So it pulls your whole body up towards the sky. So to achieve this, you do put your chin in and head up. This is head hanging. Shoulders. Relax your shoulders, meaning when we raise our arms, okay, you would not use your shoulder much. So even though if you're pulling up, okay, if you feel this is so tense, you're using muscles, then this is not relaxing. Just simply raise your arms and you may still feel that your shoulders is soft and it's not tense or not pulling. Elbows. In Tai Chi, we use the term sink or heavy elbows, meaning, okay, in the first move of Tai Chi, you raise your arms, so it's a relaxed shoulder, and then sinking the elbow. Okay, so this is to emphasize that when we bring our wrists or hands back, we are not doing this or we are not doing that. Okay, we sink our elbows and bring your hands back. We will talk in more detail when we go to the form. Your chest and upper back. Okay. You're not doing this. No, you are doing this. Okay. So either way, your spine will probably go this way or the other way. You want it to be straight, so it gives support to your upper body. So just in the middle, in between, and your chest should be relaxed and not tense. So even you breathe, you inhale, your chest will open, but it does not mean it will expand like this way. Just gently expanding your chest, but you still maintain it in the center of your alignment. Same as your back, upper back. You are not doing this, okay? So just maintain it straight and relax shoulder, head hanging. Your waist. Relax your waist and drop the buttocks. Okay, meaning in doing Tai Chi, our head hanging, stretching this part of the neck, and relaxing your waist and dropping buttocks. So what you actually do is, I put my hands here to emphasize, I relax the waist and drop the buttocks. You see that this gap actually expanded. But I'm not doing this. Okay, and if I do it this way, I break the balance. If I stretch, relax my waist and draw my buttocks, my balance still maintained. So you align, if you hang head hanging, your ears should be aligning with the vertical alignment with your shoulder, and it goes all the way along your body, and it should align to the hip. And eventually, you go through to the ankle and heel. Your legs should be standing straight up, aligning your shoulder points. You'll feel that this point here run all the way along, straight vertically down. Then it goes to the hip, and it goes down, pass through the knees, and to your ankle. The toes pointing to the front. So to measure, an easier way to measure the width of the separation between your feet, it would be a total of 3 feet wide. So you get 1 foot wide, and then 2, and then 3. So that gives you a rough idea. You may go slightly wider or slightly narrower, but this should be your standard steps. In Wu style Tai Chi, when we're standing, we normally don't do this. So now I'm a little bit of like an A shape. Now this is more an X shape. So you draw two vertical lines here, and my waist like a horizontal line, so it forms an H instead of an A.